Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let's all stand in here. Give your neighbor a great big God bless you. Tell him you love him and God loves him. Give me C, Pastor C. And say, neighbor, there's no need to worry, for God never fails. Everybody, God never fails.
I'm gonna give God praise in this place. Hallelujah. If you really believe he never fails, come on and give him praise. Oh, bless you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. While you remain standing this morning, we're gonna get ready for our responsive reading, which will be followed by a morning hymn. When you have it, please say amen.
Amen.
We praise God.
We
worship God. We thank God.
Amen.
Oh,
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And you can be seated in the house of God.
Glory.
At this time,
God,
we're going to get ready for our scripture readings this morning. The Old Testament scripture will be coming from Elder Hagans, followed by the New Testament scripture coming from Elder Tanisha. Let's receive them by saying amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him one more time.
Praise the Lord.
We serve a great, great God. Our Old Testament scripture this morning is found in the 130th division of the Psalms, verses 1 through 5.
Yes, God.
Out of the depths I have cried to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If you, Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you, that you may be feared. I wait for the Lord.
Yes.
My soul does wait, and in his word do I hope. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, and the believing of his holy word.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord
one more time. Amen. I'll be reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 35 and 39, and it reads, who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Just as it is written, for your sake we are being put to death all the day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. But in all these things we're overwhelmingly conqueror through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature thing will be able to separate us from the love of our God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Now, if Jesus is your Lord and you've come to give him some praise today, stand to your feet like you know him and give God some praise.
Thank you.
Can I get one witness out there somewhere? Touch somebody and say, while I'm still here, he keeps on doing great things for me. Turn around and tell somebody else, he keeps on and on and on and on doing great things for me.
Things he's done. When I was down.
Jesus never failed. Where my church at? Jesus never failed. Heaven and earth may pass away, but Jesus never fail.
Oh, Jesus, He never failed. Jesus. One thing I know, that heaven, somebody ought to say heaven and they shall pass away. Oh, but Jesus, He never failed. Can somebody say with me, I tried Him, and He's never failed. Is there anyone in here that ever tried Him? Have you tried Him? I dare you to clap your hands and say, He never failed. Oh,
But Jesus, he never failed.
Come on, somebody, give God praise. As you, Father, we bless you today. We honor you. Stand up in your manservant. Speak to somebody today, God. Be glorified. Be magnified and be exalted. Thank you, God, that you never fail. You can't fail. And we bless your name for it. Now, Father, get up in your manservant. I personally magnify you and I make you real big. Have your way in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank God. So be it. It is done. As you turn with me once again while you remain standing, please, to Psalm 130. Thank you, Pastor Jones. Thank you, Cornelia. Thank you, minstrels. Thank you, praise team. But Jesus never, shake somebody's hand and say, he won't fail. Psalm 130, verse 1, out of the depths have I cried unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If thou, Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who shall stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou may be feared. I wait for the Lord. My soul doth wait, and in his word do I hope. Before you take your seat, if you don't mind, precious people of God, just touch someone and, no, touch two or three people and tell them to keep on waiting. I don't think y'all got it yet. Touch two or three more people, tell them, keep on waiting. Matter of fact, shake them up and tell them, keep on waiting. And you may be seated in the sanctuary. Something I don't know. There is a word, but I believe, I feel it in my spirit. I think I do. We got some sanctified folk up in here today, and somebody just wants to praise the Lord for a moment. So if you want to bless him, you better go ahead. I'm gonna give you a few minutes to go ahead and bless him today. You may be seated. Go ahead and dance. Go ahead and dance if you want. Go ahead and dance if you want to. Thank you. And you may be seated if you can. Precious ones, I declare, I would just let y'all go ahead and shout and go home. But God has a word for somebody. And so y'all go ahead and have your seat. In the name of Jesus. Come on. Have your seat. Touch somebody else and say, he won't fail. I was seeking God's face. Now look, if y'all gonna praise him, go ahead and praise him and get it out the way, because I got a word. Somebody, but go ahead and get out. I'm sorry. As we consider what we believe that God has for us today, I have been, as you know, constantly trying to inject you with the principle of trusting God. Not trusting him for a thing. Just trust him and know that he has your back. The Apostle Paul writes to the Church of Rome, and he says that we know that all things work together for good for them that love the Lord and called according to his purpose. I had a number of people from across the country, literally, from San Diego all the way to Manhattan, call me these past few weeks, Miami to Chicago, call me these past few weeks, asking me, did I have my passport? And I told them, yes, I think it's still operable. But I told each of them, I tried to, because many of them were so depressed. I said, our hope, please, as believers, our hope is not in a political party. Our hope is not in who is living in the White House. Though many of us did the best we could, that's all God expects from us. And the scripture says that it is God that puts in office, and it's God that takes down. But as I've listened to you on the phone in my office, and after talking to Elder Ross the other day, and I think even my sister, and talking to Hillman, and then some of our members who are struggling, and believe me, I'm not standing here this morning to raise your emotions. Amen. I'm standing to try to help. We have struggling members, people who are dealing with clinical depression. People who have been so beat up by natural life until they don't know where to turn. You know, we can all put on a suit. Don't I look good? We can all put on a suit and a dress and a pillbox and high heels. We can all dress it up.
That's right.
But sometimes it's just like an apple. On the outside, the apple, if it's a Rome, it's red and pretty. If it's a Granny Smith, it's green and pretty. But sometimes when you cut into it, it may be brown and it may be wormy. Some of us have been infested with the worms that natural life will infect us with. Worms of depression. All of us have uncertainties. All of us are wondering what is going to happen tomorrow. I was listening to Elder Moss this morning in his class, just give me a few moments. I was listening to him when he was saying that they told him that his job was about to be phased out. I thought about my own Saran over here, who told me that his job is about to be phased out and they're trying to promote him to something else. But I told him, don't you trust in that promotion. Because as Elder Moss wrote on the chalkboard this morning, God is in it. And sometimes the phasing out is just God trying to give you more time to get out and find what he really has for you. We have to learn how to praise the Lord for the phase out. I'm gonna find my church in a moment. even in the thick of it. I'm talking about the thick of the kind of depression where you do not feel like getting out of bed. Do not think for a moment that you are by yourself.
Well, now.
But you and I, we have a God. Oh, my God. And Yeshua, he knows what you're going through. What did the writer say, Sanjay, when he said in his last verse, it matters not, any victors, how straight the gate, how charged with punishment the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. And what that means is that I'm in charge of how I'm going to handle this. Am I going to give it to God? Or am I going to try to fix it myself? And I have lived long enough to know that every time I tried to fix it myself, I messed it up. But I have had to learn how to trust in a God that I can't see, but I sure enough can feel. And so when Hezekiah, I got to get back to the scripture. When King Hezekiah was writing this, he was writing it from a place of depression. This is a man who removed the high places in Israel. He tore down the Asherah. He tore down the sex gods. He broke into pieces even the serpent that Moses made, because the people had taken the serpent and turned the serpent into an idol. The scripture says he trusted in the Lord. In 2 Kings 18, it says he trusted God more than any of the kings before him or any of the kings after him. Not only is he going through that, but he just came through a major sickness where he thought he was going to die. And the prophet came, and the prophet told him, get your house in order. But before the prophet could make it out the front door, God came and told the prophet, go back. Tell him, I'm going to give him 15 more years. And I've come to tell you, baby, don't let the trouble that comes your way hinder or diminish your trust in God. Hezekiah was a man who loved the Lord. He trusted in the Lord. The scripture says, more than any of the kings. And here he is. He's a man who paid his tithes. He's a man, he's a woman who praised the Lord. He's a person that worshiped Jesus. He's a person that kept trusting and praying. He's a person that was in Sunday school, Bible study, and service. He's a person that kept on trying to do the right thing, even when their friends were not doing the right thing. But he looked around and saw that his friends seemed to be doing okay. But he's been trying to trust God, but things in his life are not going okay. And the scripture says the Assyrians came. And the spiritual meaning of Assyria is my own reasoning, my own thinking, the way I'm looking at a situation. I want to tell you today that don't you think and don't you let how you look at a situation determine the outcome of the situation. You got to ask yourself the question, whose report will you believe? I'm catching healing, so y'all just stay with me. I'm not going to let the devil stop this one. You got to learn how to hold on when the enemy comes upon you like a flood. You got to realize that in the nick of time, the Lord God Jehovah will raise up a standard against him, because you are wrapped up and you're tied up and you're covered up. weapon that has been formed against you. Come on, somebody. Smack your neighbor and say, no weapon. Tell him if you don't believe it. Tell him if you don't believe it. Look at me. I've had a lot of weapons formed against me. But God kept me all the way. Can I say that again? Can I say that again? Y'all grab somebody by the hand and say, I had a lot of weapons formed against me. But look at me. Jesus never fails. And God brought me through every time. And when I think of the goodness of Jesus, you ain't got it yet. You ain't got it yet. Grab somebody by the hand and say, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all those times I was supposed to be dead, I was supposed to be homeless, I was supposed to lose my mind, but God stepped in. Yeah. Sanctified people. Somebody say yeah. So, I'm sorry, y'all. Sit down for a minute. And so Sennacherib, I'm almost there, y'all. Sennacherib, the king of Ashur, or the king of the Assyrians, had made a threat against Hezekiah, and Hezekiah knew that he did not have the strength to fight the Assyrians. He didn't have the strength, watch this, to fight his own reasoning. Because his reasoning told him he would be defeated. Am I talking to anybody yet? But tell your neighbor, that's God's good time. If it looks like it's impossible, that's God's good time. Because God's getting ready to bring you out and give you a praise and give you a dance like you're never happy. I feel that, John. I feel it. Turn around and tell two more people, that's God's good time. Stop worrying about it. Stop fretting over it. But praise God for it. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait. I gotta help my people. I gotta help my people. Y'all give me about 10 more minutes. Grab one more, no. Grab two more people. Say, that's God's good time. That's God's time. Your worst time is God's best time. Your worst time is God's best time. Sorry, y'all. Somebody go ahead and dance for me. Somebody dance for me. Go ahead and bless him. My God. Thank you. Now, y'all, I got to wrap this up. I promise you. I'm going to wrap it up now. I promise you. Can I say that? You know something? Deacon, this is ringing in me. I don't want y'all to think I'm crazy, but I am right now. But I need y'all to help me preach. I'm sorry. Tell somebody else, your worst time is God's best time. Your worst time is God's best time. Cause tell somebody, he's about to turn it around for you. And when he does it, don't you give nobody the glory but him. Y'all, I'm sorry, y'all. Okay, y'all, sit down. I'm almost there. And so, Hezekiah. Now, wait a minute. Now, antiquity teaches us that when Sennacherib and the Assyrians were about to make their move on the Ashata, Hezekiah, that God had just raised Hezekiah off of the bed that he thought would be his deathbed. So now Hezekiah is forced into a position of focusing on reason or God. Did y'all hear that? And so Hezekiah got shook up, just like you and I would. But then suddenly, he remembered what the prophet had said. When the prophet said, God has given you 15 more years, and it ain't been 1 year yet. So what am I worried about? Because God's got more power than the enemy that's coming against me. And if God said it, and so I'm done. Hezekiah sat down and he wrote that psalm. He said, out of the depth of my depression, I cried. Oh, I got to hand me my Bible, baby. I got to read this one right. Give me my glasses, too, so I can see it, baby. He said, out of the depths, I have cried to thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let my ears Be attentive. Now, I almost forgot something. He had already written Psalm 128 where he said, the Lord's going to bless me out of Zion. In other words, my favor is coming down and I ain't going to have to work it up. And he said, Lord, I wait for you. My soul does wait on the Lord. I'm catching hell, but I'm waiting. I don't understand, but I got a word from the Lord, and I'm waiting. Wasn't it Isaiah that said, now can you see the conversation? I'm done, y'all, but y'all got me worked up now. Can you see the conversation between the prophet Isaiah and the king Hezekiah? When the king said to Isaiah, I believe I'm going to wait for the Lord. And Isaiah meditated on it. And he stood on it. And Isaiah came back and he wrote something. He said, they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall preach Williams. They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. They shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and not faint. I just stopped by here to tell you this morning, I don't care what you're going through. Touch your neighbor and say, keep on waiting. I don't care how long it's been. Tell your neighbor, keep on waiting. Cause in God's own time, everything.
Come on, let's stand upon your feet. And let's give God some praise for his word. Come on and bless Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wait on the Lord. Oh, yes. Wait on the Lord. My God. Wait on the Lord. And be of good courage. And he will strengthen thine heart. Hallelujah. We praise God for the word of God. And at this time, if there's anyone here who desires to make the Lord their refuge,
yes, sir, yes, sir,
their Savior,
yes, sir,
their rock,
yes, sir,
hallelujah, now is the time to make that decision. Oh, yes, it is. Hallelujah. Don't let it be said too late. Now is the acceptable time of salvation. Glory to God. Is there one who wants to make that choice?
Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
If there's none, is there one that would like to make this their church home?
Glory to God.
You can come now.
Yes, God.
Bless
yes,
Jesus. God. If there be none, let's put our hands together and give God praise. Hallelujah. His word came to deliver. His word came to set you free this morning. Oh, yes, it did. Hallelujah. And you may be seated at this time. Glory to God.
We've come to that portion of our service where we worship the Lord with our giving. All believers, if you have your tithe and you're glad about it, stand to your feet. Everyone with your tithe, if you're elated to be able to bless God with your tithe. Lift your tithe up unto the Lord and let's pray collectively. Say, Father, be glorified. Bring your tithe with great joy. Father, we thank you for these gifts. Use them for the building up of your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's give God praise as the man of God comes.
As we leave this place today, so glad to see our visitors, my brother Mike Laurie with us today, and all of our other visitors. But this, in this lies your benediction. Y'all gonna help me sing whether you want to or not. I got Bamo up here who sang this thing so the other day until it rained. When peace like a river attended my way. When sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever thou hast taught. It is well. It is well. With my soul, it is well. It is well. With my soul. With my soul. And now unto him who is able to do exceeding abundantly beyond all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us, to the only God be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, the God who was, the God who is, and the God who is soon to come. Amen. Ah. Go in peace, my friend.